Well, 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 well. Another piece of media made by shitty martyr parents who want to complain about how hard it is to be responsible for a life you created. Recently, a play called All in a Row went live in theaters and has been met with sincere outrage. See, the play is about two neurotypical parents of an autistic child and the struggles therein. Except instead of the play talking about the lack of aid, civil rights, or protections for disabled people, i.e. subminimum wages being legal, labor exploitation through vocational schools, disabled people not being able to get federal aid if they're married, etc., it's just another case of parents complaining while explicitly abusing the child. For example, one of the key points in the play, and a significant spoiler, is that the mother tipped off social services specifically because she couldn't take having an autistic child. She's literally throwing away her child because she can't be arsed to research and get access to resources to raise a healthy autistic kid. And when social services drop Lawrence at a care institution, he's assigned a caregiver. A caregiver who explicitly says they believe that Lawrence, as a nonverbal autistic person, is the reincarnation of a wild animal accidentally placed in a human body. Or how about this one? In a particularly disgusting set of events, the audience learns the father has been shitting, literally defecating, on his wife's pillow and blaming Lawrence, thus leading to the child being punished for something he hasn't even done. And then there's my favorite. At one point, Lawrence is restrained in a way that can and has killed children because he has a tendency towards violent outbursts. If Lawrence was not played by a puppet, this scene would have had to be cut, but for some reason they definitely needed to keep it, so they just decided to use an ugly, dehumanizing puppet in place of the autistic child instead. We are told we should be gunning for the parents, the caregiver, and the other casual abusers. We're told that they're the good guys, and that autism is the villain. And any of you who know me, or have seen my other content talking about autism, know why this has enraged me. This whole play gives off the same vibes as to Siri with Love when it comes to, woe is me, I have to take responsibility for my child-ass sentiments. I have no sympathy for any parent who acts the way these characters do. And then we get to the puppet itself. Oh my god, that thing is ugly. Is that what they think we look like? That fucker died in the womb! He's a corpse! Jesus Christ! This is the monstrosity they use to represent Lawrence. And as you can see, it looks nothing like a human child. The fact that the only autistic character in the play isn't even played by a human being, let alone an autistic actor, child or otherwise, has upset a lot of autistic people, including me. Many of us feel that the autistic character in this play has been reduced to a prop, and in many ways, he has. It's literally dehumanizing. I'm going to take a few minutes to tear apart the excuses that the cast of All in a Row give for the puppet being used. Excuse number one, it allows us to give a far more realistic depiction of nonverbal autistic kids than an actor can give. Actually, the National Autistic Society's Director of External Affairs explicitly told us that you were advised to scrap the puppet entirely when you received consultation on realistic portrayal of autism. You were told it was offensive. You were told that it was dehumanizing, and you kept it anyway. In addition, nothing about that monstrosity of a marionette is realistic. That felt fabrication is a disgrace to theater and puppetry. The man who you put in charge of doing the puppetry itself is a talentless dunce. And the character overall is poorly written, underutilized, and generally shit. Excuse number two. Hiring a child actor would be unsafe for the child because of the violence and adult themes of the play. Then cut the violence and adult themes and actually focus on the struggles of being in a family that's treated as subhuman. Or hire a young-looking adult actor. Or don't make a play that has scenes capable of killing living beings. Also, if the play would have been so traumatizing for a child actor, why have multiple critics cited multiple children at the productions of this play? Do you not care about traumatizing children in the audience? Or how about autistic adults that have panic attacks instigated by past trauma watching your show? Do you not care about them? Or do you just want an excuse to physically abuse an autistic person on stage? All in all, the biggest problem I have isn't even about why they make excuses to use the puppet. The biggest problem I have is that instead of listening to the criticism that autistic adults have been giving, the play's PR department on Twitter has begun to use the outrage for publicity. They actively brag about the people they're hurting being hurt. It's like watching an edgy 15-year-old troll people by screaming retard into a special ed classroom and then bragging about it. I think the worst part is that this is the norm. Neurotypical parents often get so much more attention, resources, and assistance than actual autistic people themselves. Neurotypical parents have all the bestseller autobiographies, the television show appearances, the big charities like Autism Speaks. Everything around us is about supporting the parents. But when people actually living as autistic in a neurotypical world speak out about injustice and abuse, we're brushed aside or used for publicity. Just once I'd be happy to see neurotypical parents shut up and listen to autistic people, especially their own children. There are links to articles and videos covering autistic voices condemning the Puppetgate incident in the description below. Please, as a kindness to me, give them your time. Take a few minutes to listen to autistic voices and hear what we have to say. Stay safe, stay smart, and I'll see you guys next time. Hey everybody, End Card Patchwork Heart here. If you want to support my content, there are links to my Patreon and Ko-fi in the description below. Every dollar that you give means that I get to make more of these videos, feed my cats, pay my rent, and other important stuff. There are also links to my social media, so feel free to follow me there. I play video games sometimes now, so go ahead and follow me on Twitch, too. I'll see you guys next week for my next video. Stay safe, and have a good weekend!